Grace and peace be unto you. Grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father, from the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm excited to come to you in this season as we have been looking at the parables in 2016. We continue in 2017. We cannot do all the parables, but we are going to do those that are really going to send the message of the kingdom home. So I am so pleased that those of you who are encouraging, sending your prayers, I thank God, especially for my father who has really pioneered and really instilled. This is a generational blessing as I minister, as I stand here to you in the year 2017. I'm thanking God for his life. He's going to be 88 this year, and we thank God for what the Spirit of God has continued to do in his life. And I know it's a huge shoes to fill, but I continue to depend on the presence of God, the power of God, the fullness of God over my life. And I'm thanking God that I'm able to deliver the messages that he's releasing concerning the kingdom, concerning where we are heading as a people. And I thank God for his word. Without the word of God, we would be lost in the maze of this world. The things that are happening are just insurmountable. But we thank God that we're able to track what is happening based upon the word of God. So the word of God is still the measuring stick. It's still the canon that we can measure, that we can look into what the systems of this world are pointing towards, and we can measure, we can know. It is said that if you want to know that a stick is broken or crooked, you just have to get a straight one and laid parallel, and it will answer the problem. And so the measurement of the word of God, the fullness of the word of God, the release of the word of God in this season, in this time, is so powerful, so awesome, that the kingdom message is trending. We said in our last broadcast that the message is in seed form. Not only seed form, it has the power and the potential to increase. Not only that, it's in the household. So we looked at that household effect of the message of the kingdom, and the economy, the measurement, and the measurement of scarce resources and the management of scarce resources. Today we are going to look at the garment of the kingdom. We're going to look at how this powerful parable of the methodologies and the technologies of the kingdom is so applicable to this day and time. We want to look at the text today from Matthew's Gospel, chapter number 9, from verses 16. Verses 16 says, "No man putteth a piece of new cloth, or new cloth rather, on an old garment. For that which is put in to fill up taketh from the garment, and the rent is made worse." This is powerful. What Jesus is bringing to the fore in this parable is the systems of time, the Old Testament. The book of Galatians, the book of Romans, and Hebrews speaks of the transition, speaks of the timing, speaks of the systems that were built for thousands of years. But here comes Jesus. How could one man fulfill? How could one man bring into the earth realm something so powerful that the systems that were there, the garment? Notice in the parable, the garment was designed in its entirety, but there was a problem. Time played a factor. The garment could not last. It could not. So in the book of Romans, Paul deals with this issue. He says the earnest expectation of the creature is waiting for the revelation of the sons of God. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by him who subject the same in hope. So there was a problem. As much as the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, as much as God has blessed the first family and declared over them to be fruitful, to multiply, to replenish, to subdue, to have dominion, something happened to that release. Something happened. The power at which the blessing was released over Adam, the blessing was released over the first family, but they transferred the blessing into the hands of a fallen angel. They transferred the blessing into the hands of Lucifer. And because of that, the garment, the fabric could not stand time. Abraham, as much as he was blessed, he could not stand the effects of that curse that was upon his life, he had to transfer to Isaac. Isaac could not wait. So he had to transfer to Jacob. And here comes Esau. And the enemy used that transfer to try to destroy Jacob. Jacob, while leading on his staff, he begins to look at Pharaoh. And Pharaoh says, "How old are you?" And Jacob responds to Pharaoh. And he says, "My years are just a few and have been many troubled times." He said, "But I'm going to prophesy Genesis 49 over my sons because I am not able to withstand time." Before the flood, we understand from history, we understand from biblical history and theology that before the flood, men would live for over 300 years and would still be considered a boy. Their age and their experience will still be considered a boy. So before the antediluvian time frame would allow the systems to be intact, where men would live for 900. The oldest recorded man, Methuselah, lived for 960 plus years, and he had such a powerful influence over the life of Noah. So there was a time lapse. So when a man was considered to be a boy at 300, when he got to 600, he would still be considered a youth. And so you had the time lapses where he would be able to see his children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren, because he was going all the way up to 700. Ah, yes. And even though they came to that time frame, the last chapter in the book of Genesis says, and they put him in a coffin in Egypt. So the garment could not withstand the effects of the curse. Death reigned from Adam to Moses, but it was checked with the sacrifice of the lamb, the Passover lamb. Yet death still had power because Adam transferred power. But here comes the garment changer. Here comes the game changer. Here comes the new design. Here comes the kingdom message. In other words, in this powerful parable, it is showing forth that the message of the kingdom, the methodologies, the technologies of the kingdom cannot be homogenized. It cannot be mixed with anything. It cannot be diluted. It cannot be placed into any kind of organic or unorganic material to bring it into something special. No. You cannot handle it. The mind of man cannot comprehend it. The wisdom of this world cannot hold it. The powers that be cannot contain it. This is God at his best. This is God at work. And so in this powerful parable, we begin to see the strength of the garment beginning to fade. We begin to see the strength of that which was going to be transitioned. Interesting to note, in your Bibles, there is a blank page between Malachi and Matthew. Malachi happens to be the last book in the Old Testament. Matthew begins the new era. And so the old garment, there's a space, there's a blank page in your Bible. You could check that blank page. That blank page represents over 300 plus years where God said not a word. Nothing was spoken by God. There was no prophecy. There was no new revelation. Nothing happened until the angel appeared to Mary. And so the new garment was coming into being. And so the old garment tried its best. It came into the methods of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. It came into their philosophies and the way in which they saw Israel and they saw God. And so they saw the power and the presence of the new garment, the new fabric that was coming, and they said, no, we are not going to add this to anything else. We are going to destroy this. And so in the parable here, it speaks of that which God is bringing through the methodologies. It cannot be mixed. A new era is about to hit, and you have heard the terminologies over and over again, the new world order and what's going to happen with the new world order. The devil is a liar. The message of the kingdom is going to be transferred. In other words, this new fabric, this technology, this methodology is going to bring something so powerful to the surface of the planet that everyone is going to be affected. The old garment, no, it cannot. The rip, the tear. Remember when he died on that day in Calvary, it is recorded that the veil of the temple was rent in twain from top to bottom. The veil was so woven, so interwoven, that it was impossible for oxen pulling in opposite directions resurrection to tear that veil. Something supernatural had to rip that veil. Something powerful. Could you imagine that when they tried to rip his garment, the strength of the soldiers, they could not part his garment. So they had to cut it into four pieces. And so when we look at the powerful prophecies that declare that something awesome is coming, something powerful, the old is going to be placed. He's coming to fulfill the entirety full. He's coming to bring a new design, a new methodology, a new technology. So the strength, this powerful parable is speaking about the strength. Let's look at how awesome the function of the kingdom is. Now the nature of the kingdom is increase. And so everything is going to increase pertaining to the kingdom. The dynamics of the kingdom is that everything is going to get better. So as much as the old garment has been worn out and the rip is there, you cannot begin to add the new fabric to the old garment. It cannot be added to. You have to begin to change the entire garment. The new fabric is just the pattern that is saying, hey, you better get this. You better go and you better find it. So you have to seek the kingdom. You've got to find that new fabric and begin to use that new fabric to construct a whole new garment. So the methodology is going to change. The technology is going to change. The power of the kingdom is force. And so you spend time. There are many people that are going to try to spend time to add. They're going to try to sew that thing in. They're going to try to cut it into the rip. They're going to try to patch it in. They're going to use crazy glue. I don't know if they're going to use needle, thread, whatever they're going to use. It's not going to stick. It cannot homogenize. It cannot be mixed. And so the enemy is trying to use a religious mindset to bring about a harmonization, a mixing of the new fabric on the old garment. Jesus declared in the parable, he said, hey, the rent is going to be made worse. You have got to change your mind. So John the Baptist says, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So the rip that you have, the tear that you have in your life, that rip in your heart, it can only be patched in with something totally new. And I decree and declare, Jesus is the one who is going to fulfill everything. And so the rip, the rent, it's not, I should correct myself, it should not be patched in, but it should be made full, made whole, made anew with the fabric that he's presenting. And the fabric that he's presenting comes from his word. The word of God is so powerful. And so the culture of the kingdom is service. And so in this day and time, you've got to serve the Lord. You've got to run after him. You have got to be as the deer that panted for the water brook. So your soul needs to long after God. And he in return is going to give you the fulfillment. He's going to fulfill your life. And there are so many people that are operating with a rip in the fabric because they have not seen. The new fabric is saying, hey, this is what you need to change. You know, sometimes we hold on to old things. Sometimes we hold on to things that are so sentimental. And so Jesus declared the kingdom of heaven is like a man that goes into his treasure trove and brings out things both old and new. And so for the antiquity, they're priceless. For the newness, they're just beyond comprehension. And we live in such a world where there are people that are going to hold on to the old slippers, hold on to the old trousers, hold on to the old stuff. And there are those that are going to say, I need a new wardrobe. But here in the script, we decree and declare now that in this season, the change that is coming, the power of the kingdom, the dynamics of the kingdom, the order of the kingdom is structure. And so there are some things that cannot be added to. There are some things that cannot be glued. There are some things that would never stick. You have to have it from the bottom to the top, a whole new, because of time, because of what the enemy did to the first family. It eroded. It caused a corrosion. It caused a terrible breakdown in every facet. In other words, the moment Adam handed power to the enemy, he had the curse that was released upon him, where he would die eternally, where he would die spiritually, and where he would eventually die physically. And so God, in his wisdom, in his power, sent for a redeemer. In the fullness of time, he was birthed and he was born under the law, which means he became our propitiator. He became our lawyer. So the moment Adam sinned, there was no lawyer that could stand the case. So the case had to be shifted for Calvary. When Calvary came, here comes the new garment. Here comes the fullness. And so in the scriptures, you will see the garments are playing a powerful part. You will see Jacob losing his garment. You'll see Jacob making a powerful garment for his son, rather, who is Joseph. And you see Joseph losing his garment. You see Jesus losing his garment. And so the garments played a powerful part, the covering of the garment. And so we are now in a situation where the kingdom of heaven is bringing that garment of righteousness, that robe of righteousness, that full garment. We cannot use the old garments. We cannot take the old garments to try to add them to that which God is releasing to us in this season. No, the methodologies are changing. The technologies are changing. God is bringing the church full circle, where the kingdom message is about to bring us to maturity, where we're about to understand that the things and the pain that we suffered yesteryear, that the roads that we took yesteryear, the garments that we had on yesteryear, we are about to change. We are about to go into a new area of methodology and technology, where the message of the kingdom is about to hit the surface of this planet. And that which the religious mindsets that are trying to homogenize, that are trying to mix and declare that, can we get along? No, we just can't get along together. There is a difference. There is a stark contrast. It's a discrimination through distinction. Just as in Goshen, just as God declared to the children of Israel, I'm taking you up out of Egypt. There is a distinction in the wilderness. I'm separating you to be a people. We are a chosen, yes, generation. We are holy, royal priesthood. We are designed to show forth the presence, the power of God. And the old garment will always try, yes, to come and reclaim the shape. You know how it is. Twice around your wrist is your neck size. Twice around your head is your waist size. The enemy will try to measure you. Familiar spirits, debt collectors will try to come against you. But the devil is a liar. The old garment is not going to fit, because we have changed size. We have changed, yes, we have changed direction. We have changed methodologies. We have changed the terminologies and the technologies, which is very prophetic in this day and time. And so the prophetic terminologies and the prophetic dimension is upon our lives. And so we are plowing through. We are heading for a new day. And so in scripture, when you see the rewards even for the church, he gives a new robe, a garment that is white. And the rewards of the saints are sure. And so in this season, in this day and time, that which cannot add up, that which cannot transfer, that which cannot cross over into 2017, it is dead. It is ripped asunder. It is torn apart. And so we are in a new day. We're in a new season. And the robe of righteousness, put on, Paul says, put on the whole armor of God. And there is no room for that which is decayed. There's no room for that which is old. There's no room for that which is going to bring pain. There's no room for that which is going to cause our lives to have the kind of trouble. And so the worst of your yesterdays are becoming the best of your tomorrows. Yes, you. God is giving you a fresh garment. And so Isaiah becomes the prophet that is going to prophesy the transformation. He's going to give you beauty for ashes. He's going to give you the garments. Yes, the garments are going to be transferred. And so the garments of heaviness and the things that were upon your life, he's going to transfer that, and you're going to have a new outfit. And so you are dressed for success. And so the rip, the tear, the things that will cause everything that you are dealing with to be insurmountable, God is releasing a fresh garment. You are walking in the king's garment. You're walking in that place where God is going to release the fullness of the kingdom. And so when you look at the power of these parables, and we look at the power which is released, we look at the anointing that is flowing from the kingdom in the giftings. And so God is gifting us so that we can know that that thing is not going to be repaired with something new. It has to be placed away. It's going to roll it up as an old garment, and you have to put it away. The new garment is upon your life. There's a new day that is dawning. And so in this new season, the language pattern is going to change. You are going to begin to step into something so awesome, so powerful. The message of the kingdom, because the mustard seed, like the mustard seed, cannot be mixed with any other seed. It is a purebred seed. The mustard cannot be mixed because of the potency of the herb and the power at which the tree is going to grow. It cannot be mixed. Same for the garment. You cannot take the new piece and add it to the old. It is in a different class. The technology and the methodology is in a different class. And so the new clothes, the new outfit, the new release of the kingdom is coming to you. You have to be ready to receive it. Now, in the book of Revelation, chapter number 5, from verse 12, it declares that Jesus was slain to receive power. And so the power of the new is going to overcome the old. He's slain also to receive riches. And so the richness in the new fabric, it cannot be added to the old fabric. He was slain to receive wisdom. And so the wisdom of this age cannot be associated with the wisdom that God, according to Ephesians 3:10, unto the principalities and powers in heavenly places might be known by the church, the manifold wisdom of God. So the wisdom, he was slain to receive wisdom. The wisdom that is flowing, the wisdom that is coming to the fore is beyond anything. The old wisdom cannot articulate, cannot manage to match that which God is releasing in this time and season. He was slain to receive strength. And so the strength of the fabric is wearing in the old garment, but the strength of the new fabric, it's powerful. It cannot be added. You better go and get a full outfit. And so he was slain to receive strength. He was slain to receive honor. And so if you try to add the old fabric to the new fabric, honor is going to be erased from your life. Because the moment you step out with the garment and the rip, Jesus said the rip, the tear, is the rent is made worse. It means that everything that you have taught that would cover you is going to be uncovered. Hence the reason he said to the church of Laodicea, he said, you think that you are clothed, you are naked, you are miserable, you are wretched, you are poor, you are blind, because you did not move in time with the change of the technology and the methodology of the kingdom. This world is fleeting. This world is fading away. Yet the technology seems to keep it apace, but it's an old garment. And so the Lord is releasing in this time a new release upon the saints of God. He was slain to receive honor. He was slain to receive glory. And so when you have the new garment, it brings the express presence of God. The glory of God is going to fill. According to Isaiah chapter number 6, the whole terra firma, the whole earth is filled with his glory. And so the glory of God is right there. The glory, the presence of God is right there in your midst. And so the transfer and the upgrade is going to release the glory upon your life. Remember, the glory of God is not going to be released if the garment, the methodologies, the thinking pattern is old. If the thinking pattern is just saying that we can't make it, we don't have enough to do it, would God open windows in the heavens? You cannot have that kind of a mindset. Elijah told the man who leaned on the king, who the king depended on, he said, you are going to see it, but you're not going to taste of it. And so when the methodology is about to change, many people are going to question. Many people are going to wonder if it could really happen because they are so accustomed to the old garment. And so you have got to understand that the glory of God is updated. The glory of God is like updated software. It's like updated technology. The whole earth is filled with his glory. And so he has crowned us with honor. He has crowned us with glory. And we understand that he has set his glory in the heavens. According to Psalm 8, oh Lord, my Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in above the heavens. And so it's set in place. It's set in motion to be released to those who are able to upgrade and be able to take on a new kind of a garment. He was slain also to receive blessings. And so blessings are powerful. He is slain also to receive blessings and riches. And so blessings and riches are declaring to us that the quality of the new there's something added. When God does something powerful, remember Moses in the wilderness with the tabernacle, they had to use the blood of the lamb, they had to use the blood of bulls, they had to use the blood of goats, they had to use the atoning scapegoat, they had to use the blood, the sprinkling of the blood. Well, the book of Hebrews, the book of Romans, Galatians begins to bring the argument to the fore. It says, we have a better sacrifice. We have something that is beyond. He said, the old garment has faded away, but there is something new that is upon. Yes, the Son of Man has come to bring, yes, life. He has come to bring, he has come to make dead men live again. And so that which is faded, that which has caused problems, that which has eroded, that which has broken down in quality, that which has broken down in its in entirety, he has come to fulfill the whole law full. And so we decree and declare that in this season, he was wounded for riches, wounded for blessings. He was wounded to receive glory. He was wounded to receive strength. He was wounded to receive honor. He was wounded to receive power. And I'm decreeing and declaring in this season that the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. The old fabric has caused trouble. It has caused so many to go astray, so many to go to the wrong location for information. So many have gone to the lengths and breadths of the earth searching for that key, and it has always been right there. If you give him your heart, he's going to give you a kingdom. If you release everything to him, he said, cast all your cares upon me. I care for you. He is decreeing and declaring that, come, take my yoke upon thee. Learn of me, for I am meek and lowly. My burden is light. And so the enemy has placed a heavy burden upon you. It has caused the fabric in your life to wear. The enemy has placed a yoke upon your neck. And so the bruising, just like Joseph in prison, when his shackles were released, they said, put a garment upon him. Just like the prodigal son, he came home and the first thing the father said, put a robe upon him, change that garment. The old fabric could not stand the test of where he was going. And so where you are now, a change in the methodology, a change in the technology is about to take hold of our very nation, of our very people. Revival is about to come. And so the methodology of how we are praying, the way in which we had used our time, God is increasing that. And so we are changing. We can't take this new, that which he's releasing now, we can't take that for one moment and begin to try to force it upon an old garment. No, it's not going to. We have to begin to press forward. And so the kingdom is increasing. We are moving. The currency of the kingdom is faith. And so we have faith to believe that God is about to do something awesome. And so that new fabric, that new clothes, that new piece of cloth is coming. Mm-hmm. It's been formed. He's weaving that thing. He's forming that thing in the realm of the spirit. And you can see the beauty. He told Moses, he said, when you build the furniture, when you put on the garment, he said, don't just put on the ephod, but put on a robe. Let the high priest, let the priest be robed. Let the servants of God be robed. So the garments and everything that God is placing upon the furniture, he's overlaying it with gold. And he's an excellent God. He's a God that loves pomp and ceremony. He's a God that loves, yes, his name to be glorified, his people to be, to look good in the midst of everything that you're dealing with, the change and the power at which he's bringing it. Let it be done. We have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency not be of us, but be of God. So let it be done. Let the work of God, let the fabric, let the weavers, the power at which he's weaving in your life, that powerful tapestry, that masterpiece that he's preparing, let it be something new. Let it be something that is beyond comprehension in your life. Release everything to him. There's a new garment that is coming. There's a new day that is coming. Methodologies are changing. Technologies are changing. But the kingdom's message is the best change to acquire. The kingdom's technology is the best move to acquire. I'm so pleased. I'm so proud to be a part of what God is doing in all nations, all tiny island of Tobago. I decree and declare that the kingdom message is increasing. The power of the kingdom, the culture of the kingdom, yes, and the success of the kingdom is generational blessings that are coming to us. The anointing of the kingdom is that the gifts are going to be released. And even the strength of the kingdom is dominion and unity in the fullness of what God is releasing to us. The access of what we need is to understand the mysteries through the parables. And so the parables have released to us the powerful mysteries of the kingdom. And I'm decreeing, I'm declaring that the message of the kingdom is going to shift you, is going to cause you to question where you are and where you need to be. It's going to cause you to begin to acquire that which God is releasing. It's going to cause you to begin to look at the value system. Where is your value system? What has God blessed you with? What is it that you are just desiring and you have not seen? It means that you have to run after it. You have to seek the kingdom first and his righteousness. And remember, righteousness is always in the metaphor, the analogy of a garment. And so the garments of righteousness are going to be acquired in this season, because the kingdom is in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. And so in this time, in this day, in this season, the kingdom is going to be accessible. And remember that God himself is the one who is in full charge of what is about to happen. And so the new cloth is acquired. The Lord bless you today. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord lift the light of his countenance upon you. And the Lord give you peace. In Jesus' name, amen.
Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted up, the everlasting.